Magandang hapon mga puna. Welcome to Sagot ng SIBOL, our set of interviews where we sit down with young local creatives of all trades and chat about art while answering your burning questions. My name is Champa Bella, your friendly neighborhood frogman who's also a part-time 3D animated VTuber, Art Club's former IG public relations officer, turned the head of social media, and your host. Today, I am joined by...
Hello mga dude parrot chongs, I am Phoebe Singson. I am operations head and creator of Little SIBOL, Art Club's very own mascot and your co-host.
And we're actually joined by the University of the Philippines College of Fine Arts Student Council. You guys may introduce yourself for our viewers.
Good afternoon, everyone. So I am Katrina Batac, the current elected Secretary General of UP Diliman College of Fine Arts Student Council. And along with me, our fellow members.
So I am Kate Gottis, the College of Fine Arts representative to the University Student Council.
Hi, everyone. I am Jan Vashborja Tiston, the College of Fine Arts Student Council, Counselor for Community Rights and Welfare.
Great. So for our viewers who aren't aware, could you guys explain what UPCFASC is?
We're the highest representing organization for the welfare and rights of the entire student body. So not only do we focus on the projects and events for the college and giving students the opportunities that they need to grow, not just as artists, but also as people, we're focusing and highlighting how to use art for pivotal change. So it's not just personal, but also making an impact. So to better give like a breakdown of the structure of the College of Fine Arts, of course, it's under the University of the Philippines, Diliman, and it's just one of the many colleges. And under the college itself, we have what we call departments. So these are the specializations when you want to take a specific course that is targeted towards the career that you want or the specific art field that you want. So we have visual communications, studio arts, two types of studio arts, which is painting and sculpture, art theory, and two programs under art theory is art history and art education.
YCFA, it's the oldest and most prestigious art school in the country. Fun fact lang, CFA is older than UP Diliman itself. If you guys didn't know that, na before UP Diliman existed, meron ng CFA. And it was the first college to be absorbed the moment na na-established yung UP Diliman. Kami yung first college, so very cool. Tapos, yun nga, internationally acknowledged curriculum quality kasi even our own professors, active artists sila ngayon. So they're not just like teaching kasi hinire sila. They're there for a reason. And it's because highlighted and very respected artists sila in their field. And examples na lang, flex siguro ng mga alumni. If you guys are familiar or not, ito yung mga products ng CFA, si Fernando Amorsolo, Vicente Manansala, si Guillermo Tolentino, fun fact, number 2. Siya yung nag-sculpt nung UP Oblation, si Oblation, siya yung nag-sculpt nun, so tatak CFA yan. Tapos si Jose Hoya, Cesar Legaspi. So yun, these are national artists na not only known in the country, but internationally, you know, very yung works nila, they're still substantial and they're very valued, like timely pa rin sila even if like old ganun. So very known, very acclaimed artists. Flex lang ha, pero yung building namin yung pinakamagandang building.
Kasi yung pumunta ako dun, ang ganda.
Like yung mga designs gawa yung CFA ganun. So it's a very yung liberty ba, like it feels very freeing, sobrang nakaka-cultivate siya ng soul. Wow, sobrang deep. Pero ayun, iba kasi talaga yung the energy that being a student of the fine arts gives you, kasi you're constantly motivated, you're constantly inspired, kasi you're with fellow artists who have the same drive as you. Very known or one of the most awaited activities on site is the Lantern Parade. It's university-wide, but of course, the College of Fine Arts, being the College of Fine Arts, they go all the way. So it's always such a sight to see. And the College of Fine Arts, they host stuff such as the FST concert and even FST month, where artists are allowed to promote their actual artworks for possible buyers, and our students themselves are able to do murals on the college like walls,
And then we also do outreach programs. Recently, during the pandemic, there was this thing called an ISCO Ops. And then similar initiatives. And then also a very fun thing that the CFA is very always involved in is the UP Pride. So it involves concerts and performances. Because of course, the college highly promotes the inclusivity and of course, just promoting social welfare. So we're always active and vocal about our advocacies. So these are the things that just are some of the very fun activities to look forward to once face-to-face comes back.
So were you guys able to attend class back when there was face-to-face, or has your college experience so far just been fully virtual?
In my case, I was able to only do the application process on-site. I did the talent determination test and the whole everything in person, but the pandemic rolled in, so I ended up just having remote learning.
Actually, same with Ms. Kat. I experienced last 2019. Actually, I was a transferee from Technological University of the Philippines before I entered UP. So, yon, I experienced face-to-face or the traditional talent determination test, and I also experienced the virtual or the modern one or the latest TDT.
I think I'm the only one who's different here because I wasn't able to attend any on-site or face-to-face like tests or talent determination stuff. What I did was I just submitted my portfolio online, and because I graduated senior high school in 2020, I didn't get the chance to experience any on-ground classes.
What can you say the biggest difference between face-to-face and virtual classes has been? What are some struggles you've encountered, especially with your course?
Personally, yung masasabi namin na mas maganda or mas nakakatuto kasi hands-on yung nangyayari kapag face-to-face rather than sa virtual. Kasi parang nalilimit kami na ito yung gawin namin compare sa face-to-face na mas mainam kasi mas na-express namin kung ano talaga yung dapat namin ginagawa and mas nagiging hands-on kami.
The difference I could imagine is primarily the difficulties when it comes to actually being more involved in the CFA community. A very common struggle is between, of course, the professors and the students, because even professors themselves express that it's more difficult to teach because they aren't able to overlook your work in real time. So often we have to resort to sending works in progress and consultations, and it's just really not the same. And there's also a difference in the time that it takes to make projects, because in the college we actually have this workshop where students can go to have materials and everything that they could borrow or the college could lend for them to improve. Because of course, when you have specific tools and materials, things get done quicker. Things that take 3 days with normal tools could be shortened into a few hours if you were in, you know, doing it on site with the actual workshops that the school provides. Currently, of course, even with the remote learning setup, we still have to pursue and persevere engagements with the community to keep it alive and connected. So our activities, of course, resort to virtual things. So we have to kind of maneuver and adapt to that when it could be something that could be done on site. So it's also difficult since planning these things, it requires cooperation and involvement of your different constituents, which is more difficult if you have to do it online. Because of course, people have their individual lives, they have other things going on. And it's much different when you're just there in person. Kasi yun at yun lang yung aasikasuhin mo. But right now we're at home, facing different factors, the pandemic just being one of them. So there's a lot of lapses talaga. So we have to always continue the call for ligtas na balik eskwela.
It's very difficult for me kasi I didn't graduate arts and design on senior high school. I'm actually a STEM student. I'm supposed to major in pre-med, but I decided to take fine arts. So I'm starting from the bottom talaga. And YouTube tutorials are never enough. And I think the difficulty here is yung pag may finished product ka and need mo siya ipakita sa prof mo. Kasi your finished product is never your finished product in fine arts. Like, pag pinasa mo siya na fully rendered, ang laking kasalanan nun sa art prof mo. So, yeah, you have to consult and consult. And yung difficulty to is you have to take a picture of your artwork. Tapos pag pinasa mo siya, pwedeng mali na yung proportions nga sa picture kasi syempre nabibend yung papel, pangit yung angle mo. So, it's not accurate. So, yung ginagawa ng isang prof namin is dinadrawingan niya yung studies namin gamit iPad niya. And, well, it's a big help. Sobrang, we can really feel the difference. Kahit hindi pa kami nakapag-F2F, we can feel the difference if we were seeing our profs in, ano, harap-harapan talaga.
Nagiging fuzzy yung instruction na binibigay ng mga prof kasi hindi nila ma-express through words usually dahil mas maganda na hands-on or na-demonstrate nila ng maayos yung instruction na nagagawa. Kaya minsan, or always rather, na ano, nakaka-experience kami na parang akala namin yung interpretation based sa instruction na yun. Ganito. Pero yung pala, iba yung sinasabi ng prof. So we need to repeat the plate again.
For our viewers, and I guess if to inform you guys na rin, so we have an ongoing series called Pursuing Art in College because we know how difficult it is, it can be, to gather information about the college application process, especially as homeschoolers. But even if you're not homeschooled, we hope you find this video helpful. We asked our viewers to send their questions about pursuing art in college, and today we will be asking them to you guys. Are you guys ready?
Yep.
All right, so first question. What course are you guys taking up?
Mine is actually a bit different from my other council mates. Mine is under theory, the Department of Theory. I'm taking up art education. So imagine if fine arts and education basically had a child. Because my program is designed for aspiring art teachers, professors, and things like that. So while I have major subjects that require actual plates, plates are basically what we call yung output namin, so the artworks that are assigned to us. So I have about 4 of those per sem. So imagine each subject has a lot of requirements, so a lot of plates. And along with that, I have EDUC majors, which are classes that I take that are very technical, so that involves the bylaws of being a teacher and, you know, the constitution and whatnot, the very technical paperwork-y type of stuff. Because while I have to study what it means to be a teacher, how to be a great teacher, I also have to, of course, be very honed in my skill as an artist, because how could you teach something if you're kind of bad at it?
Me and Kate are actually on the same department and we're black mates, so we are sophomores taking up Bachelor of Fine Arts in Visual Communication. So to be specific, it's more on graphic design and then illustration, animation, photography and such, advertising and marketing as well. Yun, medyo close siya doon, or specifically yun siya, yung field na tinatahak naman. Pero yung pinagkaiba lang kasi neto, though lahat kami is parang nakakapag-adjust agad sa time, sa setup natin ngayon na remote learning. Pero ano, mas maganda kasi, or mas nakakapag-innovate kami or nakakapag-isip kami, nagiging creative thinker kami kapag magkakasama, kasi hindi naman kami sanay na face-to-face lang, kasi since advertising and marketing, na iniisip natin hands-on sa gadgets and tech stuff. Pero ano, mas maganda kasi, or mas nakakapag-solve kami ng problem kung mas nakaka-generate kami ng idea na magkakasama actually.
And like these like icons seen here, if the students watching this would want an actual glimpse in what it's like in our programs and what we do, this isn't a plug, okay? You guys aren't required to follow us. Pero I think it's mas masaya siya when you actually see it raw as it is. Na parang in that moment, that's what we were dealing with. Na so nandun like our works in progress, ganun. So these are Instagram accounts. So you guys can look at these highlights, because these highlights are, you know, more stories that we put whenever we're doing plates, you know, staying up late para makapasa again.
What's the application process like for UP and how long does it usually take?
This is the basic structure of the application process. So of course you have to take the UPCAT. I'm not sure how it's gonna work in the coming months kung magkakaroon na ng on-site UPCAT, but typically that's how it happens first. You take the UPCAT, and then since university has this what we call like a cutoff grade, which is your general average from your high school subjects, and they have this grade that you should meet alongside passing the UPCAT. So, and these are the standard requirements such as the birth certificate, good moral, and Form 137 or 138. And then when you pass the UPCAT, so that's just one hurdle. Yeah, these are things that happen department that is taken at the department level. So we have the IQ and aptitude test. It's a multiple choice exam. It's not very technical. Like hindi siya yung exam na tulad ng UPCAT na general knowledge and there's maths. IQ and aptitude test, if you guys are familiar with it, usually they're just like shapes and then you see the patterns and then you choose the best answer and stuff like that. And then the actual talent determination test, usually of course it's done in the college. And it's a real-time creation of artwork. So there's a time limit, and then usually there are proctors going around giving you instructions. And then next is the portfolio review. It has 10 to 15 artworks, and then you're supposed to get your old ones. You choose your best ones. And then the department, your department coordinators who are helping you process it will give you specific instructions about 2 to 3 artworks. So it depends on the department on what artwork they want, but usually they say like a prompt like parang make an artwork based on this or something like that, and it's 2 to 3 artworks. You're gonna submit that, and then next when you do that you have the department interview. So there's a panel of CFA faculty and admins who will ask you questions about your portfolio, and they'll also be requiring an essay alongside submitting your portfolio. And then generally you as an artist or a student and an applicant of the CFA. So yeah.
ano, explain talaga. Like, I actually understood that.
Do you have any tips or words of wisdom you'd like to share with our viewers?
What I would like to advise everyone is to not follow what I did, because I completed my portfolio in only 1 month. Took me 1 month to complete 15 artworks, and that was really hectic because I was at the hospital at that time when I decided to apply for FA. So it's stressful because of course you need to make more than 15 artworks. Like, I'd really advise everyone to make more than 15 artworks, both digital and traditional, because you have to pick your best. From all of the artworks you've created, you need to pick the best ones. You need to consult your friends, your family, sino papiliin niyo kung anong artwork yung tingin nilang pinakamaganda. And take criticism. It's also important to watch like YouTube videos, like art students explaining their portfolios, how they, what yung content mismo ng mga portfolios nila, how they passed a certain art school. And you can also research through Twitter, Facebook, and sometimes kasi yung mga nakapasa ng FA, pinupost nila yung portfolios nila doon. I posted mine actually. And during that time when I was panicking, I didn't know kung ano yung standards or what I need to live up to. Like, ano ba yung itsura ng mga artworks na kailangan ko i-produce or kano kaganda ba sila dapat. So, looking up, searching for portfolios ng mga art students really helped na i-bring up ko yung level ko. Because I realized, oh, hindi pala enough tong artwork na to kasi compare natin siya sa ibang mga nakapasa. Like, iba talaga yung level niya. Ganun. And, like, you can ask alumni or mga people mismo sa loob ng college na yun. Friendly naman mga FA. Like, sumasagot kami. And especially sa, ayun, yung council, you can actually ask the council for help sa application process. So, I didn't have those at the time. Actually, no, I didn't ask CFA council kasi, of course, holdover term noon, like, patay na yung mga tao. Because yung council nila noon, 2 years na nagsaserve. So, pagod na sila. Pero, I reached out to alumni ng CFA. Friends ko kasi sila since 2018 pa magkakakilala na kami. So, they guided me, a prof from UP Baguio helped me, like, ginudge nga yung portfolio ko. And it was, like, a really big help kasi as a walang experienced person na nag-rush ng portfolio for 1 month, it was like a miracle na nakapasa ako na LA. So, ayun lang for me.
On my side, so yun, each respective discipline or specialization has their own ways of criticizing and filtering artworks. So, do not be bothered by your learned skill or learned technical skill. Just be yourself. Kasi mas maganda siguro na naikukwento mo kung ano yung experience mo dun sa visual na yon, rather than gumawa ka lang para lang makapagpasa. Kasi kahit na ba gaano kakatagal nag-prepare for the CFA TDT, kasi marami rin akong friends na nakakilala rin na magaling talaga siya when it, magaling sila when it comes to skills and such. Pero yun nga, mas maganda na paghahandaan mo ng may story or kaya mong i-narrate or kaya mong may social relevance yung mga artworks na ipapasa mo. Kasi kung wala naman yun, tas hindi siya from your, from the bottom of your heart. Parang you are just there just to enter the school. Ganun lang. Or the institution. Pero kaya ka nga pumasok doon kasi you want more for yourself. Na alam mo na matututo ka at matututo ka sa mga prof mo and sa mga sa environment mo kung nasa saan ka. So you are yourself and don't let pressure ruin your dreams. So and kasi by that, you could unleash your inner artist.
My word of advice naman when it comes to preparing your portfolio is starting now. Try to find time. Like when you have free time, just do sketches when you feel inspired or even when you don't feel inspired. The thing about like finding your inspiration is that people often think that artists start when they have the drive or the mood for it. Pero when you end up sticking to that, you're always going to end up thinking that, yeah, I don't want to make muna ganun. So you persevere na parang I'll make this because I want to study this anatomy, this concept, because I want to convey this message. So by that time, from this timeline up to the point that UPCFA releases application processes, you already have a collection of artworks to choose from. And then you can just choose, oh, this one, I feel like this one's pretty cool. So when it comes to the actual technicalities of the portfolio, word of advice is make it simple. Kasi when you present something to like the institution, you're gonna think, oh, I have to really impress them. But you're presenting your artworks, not the actual portfolio itself. So don't let the layout overpower it. Be simple, be direct, because they focus on the artwork and the impact that it causes. So again, what also Bash mentioned, which is that be yourself. I know it's very gasgas, it's very cliche, but when you think to yourself that you're not ready or you're not worthy to apply to the college, that's actually the best time to apply. Because when you enter the CFA thinking that you're already a great artist, then why should you still apply? You're going to enter there because you want to study, you want to improve. So if you have that drive, palang na parang I'm not ready, but I want to try, I want to improve, then that's the time you enter. And in doing that, you have to be true to yourself. One of the very great lessons that I got from my first year was when one of my profs actually said, "You're not here to impress me," which is very contradicting to your expectations. Because when you enter the seemingly prestigious high-end art school, you're gonna think that you're very pressured, that there's these expectations that, oh, I have to get an uno, I have to impress my profs because they're such great artists. No, you're there because you want to evolve, you want to grow as an artist. If your goal is to impress people, then you're doing it wrong. Because the only progress that you should track is how you were as an artist yesterday and not who you have to convince that you're a great artist. So they can, and in doing that, if you're entering the college with like these pretenses, the profs in the college itself won't be able to assess you properly. So yeah, always just be true to your nature as an artist, because that's the best way to start off.
Ano, sa tingin ninyo guys, why is it important for to make a portfolio, and how can it be useful in the future? Like you can show it to people or something. How is it like that?
Can I answer first, Kat and Kate?
Go ahead.
So yeah, personally, if you're going to enter the UP College of Fine Arts, you need portfolio, not just as foundation or sinasabi natin na baod mo pagkapasok mo ng UP. Kasi ano, madadagdagan siya. Tapos makikita rin yung improvement mo. Ikaw, makikita mo sa sarili mo yung improvement mo na ay at least pagkapasok ko ng fine arts, nandito ako hindi dahil magaling ako. Nandito ako dahil marunong ako at gusto kong matuto. So by that kasi, yun, ipapasok ko na lang din. Meron kasing tinatawag na Associate in Arts and Bachelor of Fine Arts. So if you're Associate in Arts, you have 2 years to finish the program or the certificate course in order for you to step up to Bachelor of Fine Arts. So yung 2 years na yun, kailangan mo magkaroon ng portfolio na not to impress the faculty or the admin of the College of Fine Arts, but to prove to yourself na nag-grow ka as an individual, as an artist, to continuously make a difference. For me, ayun yung purpose ng portfolio.
Because what I think is the significance of giving your portfolio is I see it as a benchmark. Now, when you entered or applied to this college, this is where you were at with your skill level and how you were creating these things. Tapos, ayun, like what Vash said, you don't do it to impress the admins or the faculty. Because if that was the case, edi sana they gave slots to, like, parang there's no point in choosing the best of the best, diba? Kasi parang, like, I see it as giving your portfolio because they want to see the potential. Of course, they're going to view these artworks. Like, if you think about it, these are the professors in the college are very well known and they're very highly respected in the art field. So when it comes to these technicalities in criticizing artworks, of course, they're going to see these artworks from amateurs, from very young students, and they're going to end up thinking, like they're going to see like these flaws or errors. And that's where they see the potential. I said the potential relies on room for improvement. So yeah, that's the importance of your portfolio and why ngayon pa lang guys, try nyo na gumawa ng artworks. Huwag nyo kami tularan na kung kailan nagbigay ng processing applications. Tsaka pa lang kami gumawa ng artworks. It is trying to say naman is that when you do enter, like when you become a student in the fine arts and you spend 4 years there, ideally, you get to look back on your portfolio and see, ganito pala ako mag-drawing ngayon. So you see, you know, like actual tangible things that you can point out na how you grew. And it's very great to look back on kasi it highlights the concept of progress ganun, and how you'll always have room for improvement. Like learning never stops talaga.
Looking back, you're like, ooh. Okay. So we also received some questions from Mika Bada, who's currently grade 10. So she asked, what are your thoughts on Filipino parents not supporting their child in their pursuit of art, and any advice?
Give an advice to for students who feel like their parents are hesitant about it, is let your passion prevail. Like if you, like from the get-go pa lang, alam mo sa sarili mo na I want to pursue art, you stick to that. Because if kung sa'yo pa lang, nakikita na ng parents mo na you're hesitant or you're worried or you're anxious about it, mas may inganyo sila to convince you na, edi huwag ka pumasok or ganun. So if you hear, yun nga, those notions na wala namang pera sa art, which isn't true by the way. if you look at our current, you know, like yung, like our society, artists are very, very in demand. And again, of course, granted naman na money is important to sustain your life, pero if that's your concern, then honestly, it's not really a problem. Kasi especially when you love what you're doing, when you do the things that you do with love, you're never going to fail. Kasi your passion is continuously going to push you to do your best. And when you do your best, honestly, it's inevitable that great things come to you, like opportunities, what do you call this? Like offers, partnerships, things like that. I would like to cite this quote that my dad used to say that I used to raise an eyebrow on, pero he told us, like us siblings, na you do what you love and you work hard so that you don't have to find you don't have to find the job, because jobs will look for you. Like that's honestly, that's going to happen. Like I'm saying it right now. Kasi if you put your heart and soul in what you're doing, you're going to end up giving like the best outputs, like the best, like the quality. And I don't mean best na it's perfect, but also when people see that you're very sincere in what you're doing, ang dami mong energy in what you're doing, they're going to gravitate towards you. And I'm saying this like in full honesty, I'm not like putting flattery around being an artist. It's just true. Na it's a very like it just things just come to you when you do what you love. So when you have parents who seem hesitant, you just show them, you take your stand that no, I really want to do this. And like ayun nga, na parang it would be very disappointing. Like you remind them na what's the point in pursuing what they want if you're ending, you're not even doing it out of your own volition. Because if you're forced to do something,
the quality of your work is going to decline. Like, it's just logic. If wala kang energy, wala dun yung passion mo, wala dun yung puso mo, it's going to be half-hearted. And I feel like that's way more disappointing than disappointing your parents by taking a course that they don't approve of.
Grabe, hindi ako makaredit sa kanila. Char, kasi... Wait lang. Pili, lag na naman ba ako?
Okay na, Kate.
Okay, sorry. So, yeah, I come from a family of businessmen, engineers, and doctors. So you can imagine the struggle na nag-decide ako mag-FA. Actually, bata pa lang ako. I wanted to pursue FA. I wanted to take FA since I was like sobrang liit ko pa kasi if I can remember preschool pa lang ako nagda-drawing na talaga ako and I was like taking interest talaga sa pagte-take ng fine arts kaso like reunions are parang that's the most hated event of every year kasi you get to meet yung mga businessmen mo tito, yung mga doctor mo tita or mga relatives mong nasa science, nasa STEM field and then sinabi mo, I'm gonna take fine arts. And then they look at you with the disgust talaga. What? You're doing what? So, ganun. And one time, actually, may lola ako na galing States. She went home and then she told me na, you're thinking of fine arts? My daughter took up fine arts and tingnan mo, she's a tattoo artist na lang ngayon. And actually, that's an inspiration kasi a tattoo artist gets like 2,000 to 5,000 pesos per tattoo. So that's in the Philippines. Pero paano pa kung sa ibang bansa? So malaking pera na yun actually. You imagine na limang tao yung magpapatattoo sa'yo sa isang araw. So, ayun. And then, eventually I lost. So when I was in senior high school, I had to take up STEM. Because yun, they planned na I'll take up pre-med instead of taking fine arts. And I was okay with that. Until I wasn't okay with that because I was flunking STEM. So, what I learned from that is that it goes to show na when you're doing something that you really hate, like I really hated STEM at that time. I hated physics. I hated chem. I was crying when I was doing my chem lab work. Sabi ko, I'm supposed to be drawing right now. And I flunked really hard na I didn't like going to class because I hated what I was studying. I hated what I was doing. And then I failed UPCAT. Like, oh my god, what am I going to do with my life now? And I got the news that I passed one exam on Bulacan State University, but it was for nursing. And then I decided, am I going to go through this hell again or am I going to do what I want? So I was in the hospital and then they told me, hey, Kate, may talent test na for your UP Fine Arts. Sabi ko, may isang buwan na lang ako para mag-take. Sure ba kayo? Sabi nila, yeah, go mo lang. Like, ano daw ba yung mawawala? So, I took the test. Nagpasa ko ng portfolio. And yeah, I passed. So, ayan, yung program ko is what Bash mentioned earlier. It's the Associate in Arts program. So, if ever hindi kayo makapasa or may mga nag-inspire dito na mag-UP pero hindi nakapasa ng UPCAT, like, you can still get into UP or you can still get into Fine Arts. Just really do good in your portfolio. And yeah, nakapasa ako yung FA. I have a 1.29 GWA. Flex lang. So, dean sister ako. So, sobrang laking difference niya when I was studying science. Kasi no STEM ako, I was receiving grades na 75. So, and now, puro una yung iba kong subject. So, when you're doing what you do, parang masaya siya and stressful siya. I'm not saying na madali lang FA, pero if you're doing something that you really like, you're going to excel in it talaga compared to doing something that you don't like and then pinipilit mo lang yung sarili mo everyday na gawin yung bagay na yun dahil sinabi na ibang tao. So, it's a big deal, lalo na sa mga magulang natin what we're taking as a course. So, my mom didn't really approve of it nung pumasa ako ng FA. She didn't talk to me, she didn't even congratulate me. Pero, actually ngayon, pinapromote ko na ako. Like, she's telling me, uy, pag-graduate mo, Kate, ito yung gagawin mo. Ga-apply ka sa trabaho na ito, tapos i-refer ka sa kaibigan ko na ito, papasok ka dito. Tapos ibenta mo yung artworks mo dito sa kanya. Kailan yung exhibit mo? Ganun-ganun na siya. She's really supportive right now. So, it's a roller coaster getting your parents' approval. Pero promise once that they accept it, it's like, you're in heaven. Like, ang saya-saya ko. Kasi, saya-saya ko ngayon. Like, She loves what I'm doing. She's telling me what to do next. She's recommending stuff. And she's buying my materials right now. That day ako kasi yung bumibili ng materials ko. And now she's paying for it. And ayun, you're studying what you love pa. What you love pa. So, sobrang euphoric. And sobrang saya niya nung feeling na accepted mo yung ginagawa mo. That you didn't turn back on what you want to do. So now, your parents support you. So, tama nga yung sinabi nila dati. Ano yung mawawala sa'yo? So, you only have something to gain. So, yeah, I gained a lot. So, that's why I use now ngayon. And I'm really doing well. Ayun na.
And if ever man, because often yung hesitance ng parents is like magastos or like, why should they invest their money in an art course that has doesn't have the same significance as like engineering or whatever, ganyan. Pwede kayo mag-apply sa UPCFA. Wala kaming tuition. So yeah, guys. If you need extra bala to convince your parents that I really want to be an artist, apply kayong CFA. Kasi well, they can't use that card against you na ang dami naming ikagastos.
Yeah, agree. It was just the materials.
Be a scholar ng bayan. Kasi
scholar ng bayan.
When you're under the CFA, it's very highlighted that you're not just making art for yourself. You're making art to make a difference in society. And I don't just mean makita nila yung artwork mo, they're gonna get moved. But there are also involvements when it comes to programs, initiatives. You have these on like groundwork and actual tangible actions that you get to be involved in making a positive change in society. So it's very promising. It's not just drawing lang.
The next question from Mika. Do you think what college you come from affects the way you perceive yourself or others as an artist?
Okay, so I think it's very common now when you hear na someone's from UP, it's like, oh, diba? But honestly, it's like it has its history and it has its merit, like for reason, ganun. But so do other universities. It just so happens that historically speaking, UP is the oldest like art school, and given that, I think like dun palang it's also like the most prominent one since like dun lang galing yung mga national artists and whatnot. But what is history when you're a current student, like in the present, and you have these potentials that you have to release into the world. So it's not about where you come from, but what you do with that, with the opportunities, the environment that you have, and how you make the most of it. Like, there's always going to be, I feel like, an inevitable naman yun, that there's always going to be this air of snobbery when you hear the word UP, but tinan mo naman kami. Kenkoy. just like everyone else, we're pretty clueless. We're just doing what we can to get by. We're doing our best. We're just like any other art student. Because I do believe each and every art student is passionate and they're doing what they love. Dogs. So yeah, that's the common ground. Art students are very passionate. They do what they love. What does having a different university set us apart from that? Diba? As long as you're sincere and honest and you release your full potential for growth, that just makes you a great artist on its own.
When I was told, oh, champ, you're gonna... Champ Phoebe, we're gonna be interviewing UP students. I was like, hi, UP!
But
this is... baka formal dapat kailangan. Pero ngayon, I'm like, ah, chill lang! We're just chilling. Chill lang naman pala.
Grandma din was also from UP. So, when my dad heard about this, she's like, you should tell your grandma about this. I'm like, okay. Tell Lola about this. I'm like, okay, sige.
I told my mom again and she was like, who are you? Yeah, I was, okay, have fun there. And I was like, am I supposed to take that as, uh-oh. Pero okay, no, I know.
With the lack of mainstream and affordable universities that offer tracks related to art here in the Philippines, would you really consider it to be worth the money?
When it comes to like, yun nga, given the context of like the CFA, wala kaming tuition. But of course, that doesn't mean wala kang iwawaldas na pera. Meron at meron kang gagastusin. Because that applies to any other program, any other thing that you want to pursue, you're going to end up spending money. And when it comes to its value, money can be returned to you eh. Babalik at babalik yan sa'yo. But the skills that you learn, the knowledge that you gain, and the experiences that you go through, these aren't things na ma-equate mo sa pera.
So I'm not saying you belittle the money that you have and the money that you spend, but think of it as an investment. Just be wise about it, of course. So when you're going to pursue something and you're going to put money into it, just make sure na you're spending it on the right things. Na para assess it, consult with your parents, people who are actually financially literate. And just make sure that when you buy things or when you have, like you correspond with people, when you have like this trade, na you're not going to be taken advantage of. Because the thing when it comes to young artists or just anyone who's young, getting into things and want to invest into things, it's a common thing naman for people who are more knowledgeable to take advantage of that, na parang they're gonna overprice you. So it doesn't hurt to ask for help, especially for people who know, who have been in the industries, ganun. Be smart about your decisions. But when it comes to spending money, no matter where you go, you're gonna spend money. So may as well spend it on something you love doing.
Worth it siya actually, yung gastos. Kasi magiging, sa CFA, matututo ka maging smart-wise rather than purchasing something na alam mo porket ganito yung quality, high-end yung price, then high-end din yung quality or yung brand. Hindi na siya ma-achieve or hindi na siya same quality with lower prices. Magiging smart-wise ka in a way na magiging innovative ka na hindi lang ito yung source of materials or medias na gagamitin mo na pwede ka pa rin namang makakuha ng iba ng ibang medium na ma-achieve mo yung quality na hinahanap mo. Then sa CFA naman kasi, CFA community is like a family and a home talaga. So tulungan lang din talaga sa loob ng CFA community ka, kasi kung sabihin mo na parang financially struggling ka, magsabi ka lang sa mga friends mo, then iikot at iikot siya sa loob ng community mismo, kahit na masabihin mo na hindi mo ka-close yung mga nasa higher year mo, pero magtutulungan at magtutulungan pa rin naman. Dahil yun nga, nagpapasahan ng commission minsan yung mga higher year, so since hindi na nila gagamitin yung mga media na to, ipapamigay nila. And then lahat naman ng gastos sa first year, especially first year yung masinasabing magastos, magiging investment po siya throughout your stay sa College of Fine Arts. So worth it talaga.
So baka kasi isipin din ng mga tao na since art puro materials yung kailangan talaga, ang dami mong bibilhin, but you're an art student, you're bound to get creative, you're bound to get innovative. And contrary to popular belief, profs aren't snobby when it comes to wanting brands, or they don't ask for brands. They do mention what they prefer when it comes to their own artworks, but it's not like they'll give you a cinco because you didn't buy the brand that they want. In fact, they encourage you to explore other ways instead of buying. Because of course, given na you want to limit your expenses as possible because money doesn't come easy, diba? So there are more ways than just give out money, buy new things. You be creative. You find ways to still achieve what you want to achieve without constantly buying new things. So you
okay. I want to reiterate that Bash said na maging streetwise. Tama yun. Dahil wala ko alam sa FA, on my first sem, I spent 12,000 pesos on my materials. Kasi apparently, pwede palang mag-watercolor nang hindi ko gumagamit ng 1,500 pesos na brand. Kasi yung ginagamit ng pala nila sa FA ay prang like 500 pesos lang or 300 ganun. Tapos, ang ganda na ng results. So, binili ko siya nung naubos yung sobrang mahal kong watercolor. And, ayun, I spent 500 lang. So, on my second year, ngayong year, I spent at least 3,000 pa lang yung nagagastos ko ngayon. At compared siya sa last year, talaga na sobrang laki. So, ayun, if we're going to talk about kung worth ba yung gastos, worth it siya. Kasi before entering FA, before buying the materials, sobrang hate na hate ko talaga lahat ng dry medium. Sinusumpa ko siya. Ayoko talaga na gamitin siya. Charcoal, ayoko niyan, sorry. Soft pastel, ayoko niyan, sorry. Magda-drop out na lang ako. Pero hindi, ayun, natutuwa ko gumamit. Ayun, nakapag-blend ako ng colors. Marunong na ako mag-render ngayon. So, small price, hindi siya small price to pay, pero required to pay yun talaga. Pero worth it naman yung magiging outcome niya. Kasi kung wala yung mga materials na yan, hindi ka rin talaga matututo. Pero siguro emphasize na lang na mas malaki yung gastos ngayong online learning compared sa F2F, sa face-to-face. Kasi may materials na available, pwede ka manghiram sa kaklase mo, pwede ka manghiram, huy, may ano ka ba, ganun, kasi babalik mo. So ngayon, hindi kasi, kailangan mo na talaga ng sarili mong materials, kailangan mo ng Kailangan mo ng paper. Pero mo kailangan kasi alam ko sila kat, sila gumagawa ng sarili nilang canvas. So, ayun. Tapos yung materials nun, dami mo kailangan. Kailangan mo ng nail gun, kailangan mo ng pako, kailangan mo ng ganito, ganyan.
Hindi yeah, with kailangan ng pako. In our lab.
Ah, okay. So, ang hirap. Hindi mo rin alam kung saan mo siya makukuha yung mga gamit na yun. So, mas madali talaga if nasa FTR ka, mas less yung gastos, promise.
It's an investment kasi the things that you learn and you experience are, there. It's like a value na hindi mo makuha sa paggastos. You know?
This question is from Micah Alejano.
Alejano.
That kind of release to... Okay, her question was her question was how is taking up an arts related course different from learning from YouTube?
To learn from YouTube, these are it's like a one way type of learning. So manonood ka lang and you're gonna listen. But in CFA, you have these professors. There's the history of CFA, and not just CFA, like any other university. The professors that are there for a reason, and that's because they're great artists and they know what they're doing. And they're also there because they're passionate about it. And that extends to, para it's inherently correlated to the fact that they want to share that with people. So, ayun, when you're in art school, you get to share. You get to share experiences, you get to share tips. And of course, the teachers themselves, sila mismo magka-guide sa iyo. But don't, it's not in a way that they spoon-feed you. Kasi what's the point of learning kung... So, sobrang baby steps, sobrang gabay sa'yo, diba? But they're going to be the ones that will push you to challenge yourself. To like, they'll just give you this thing that you have to work on. And then, dumiskarte ka. Kasi, pag ituturo lang at ituturo sa'yo lahat, you're gonna end up being constrained in this parang box na very cookie-cutter type artist na kailangan ganito lang yung ano. But, ayun, to be a great artist, one of my profs said is, you learn the rules and then you break it. So you have to master these certain basics first. And then you go beyond that. Kasi what's the point of, parang, how are you going to end up standing out? Kung your work is just like any other, di ba? Like, pa-follow ka ng trend, or like, you're doing this because it's what people are having a focus on ngayon. Yun yung uso. So, yeah, that's the difference between just watching YouTube. Kasi, yun nga, I do hear that notion often na, ba't pa ako papasok ng art school kung pwede naman akong pumasok sa workshop or pwede nga ako manood ng video? It's not the same. Kasi it's just a one-way transaction. You're going to end up receiving. But it's not like you could comment or you could contact the YouTube creator na pakritik naman ng artwork ko. It's not like that. Because when you have these professors, you have consultations, you have real-time feedback on what worked, what didn't. What will work if you try these things out. So, lalawak at lalawak ng pag-aaral mo, which you can't achieve just by watching videos.
A question from Day and Honor, who are actually here right now, spectating. Is there a specific art style that's more common or favored?
Coming from visual communication department, so we are professors lagi nagsasabi na dapat or kahit mga friends mo na parang uy, ito yung art style mo and such. Pero hindi naman kailangan ano, so far pumasok, yun lang lagi namin pinanghawakan, pumasok ka dito ng may rules, then ikaw na lang yung magbahala mag-break ng rules. Kasi you need to follow na hindi kailangan maging superior yung style mo porket alam namin na magaling or appealing to the eyes or pang industry level na yung ano yung style mo. So hindi kailangan na yung style mo is parang superior talaga. Like ito ba yung kailangan standard na kailangan makita ng prof? It's not about that. Kasi ayun nga, ang tinitingnan ng mga professor inside the College of Fine Arts, how you progress as individual, as an artist. Kasi kung magiging sabihin na natin na nasasabi na IUP grade conscious, ganoon, kasi more of aral lang, GC ang mga yan, kaya ano, kailangan competitive ka, kailangan superior ka lagi. It's not about that. Kasi yun nga, sa sinabi ni Kate na hindi siya magaling sa soft pastel, hindi naman siya dun iti-criticize or bibigyan ng grade. Kasi bibigyan or sa style or specific media na yun or sa style niya, ibibigyan siya or iti-critic siya based on how she improve herself sa throughout the year. Kasi hindi lang naman yung progress lang naman, hindi lang naman yan isang upuan lang. Or magaling ka na sa isang upuan or ilang araw lang. Parang kailangan mo pa mag-spend ng 3,250 hours para lang ma-master mo talaga siya at masabi mo talaga nag-improve ka. And ayun yung masasabi na style talaga na ano na hindi nagiging superior yung mga or nagkakaroon ng superiority yung mga students inside the college.
When it comes to I wouldn't say preferred, pero again when it when revolving around the belief na you learn the rules and break it. When you enter the fine arts, a lot of your majors about like two of your majors are going to focus on realism. So that is rendering artworks and subjects as accurately to life as possible. And not because it's a universal knowledge na realism as an art style is the most superior one, but also it's in the practicality kasi, like in the technical aspect of it na when you're able to convey or translate an object from real life into an artwork, then it means that you have the skills for these different principles of art, such as like composition, color, values, etc. So when you get to grow or like evolve yung skill mo dun, that's when you can branch out to the other art styles or at least hone your own art style. Because it's true, every artist has their own style, even if the artists themselves aren't aware of it. And yung style na yun, it's always going to be retained kasi nasa yun na yun as a person, like hindi na yun mawawala sa'yo. So when you, focus like ng CFA majors, especially when you're in your early years, like first year, second year, palagi kayong bibigyan ng plates na realistic yung render, and they're gonna critique you for that, for you to improve. Kasi it's not like they're teaching you to just do that, but it's because you're going to apply the things that you learned in learning realistic rendering into your own art style. Kasi it's going to show talaga in no matter art style you have, even if it's like abstract or ano. Kasi although art styles differ, although concepts differ, principles of design remain the same. Like yung mga very technical stuff, it's the same, it's all the same. So it's all in the application. So it's not so much as a preferred art style. Kasi yun nga, there's no superior art style. It's all about versatility, like diversity, ganun, diba? And so yun, it's more on just finding and mastering the basics. So you apply those basics into branching out to your own style and evolving as your own individual artist. Kasi when you graduate from the CFA, hindi mo naman pwede ibit-bit yung mga professors mo, diba? But you're going to just have everything that you learned from them. Tapos you're on your own. So at least may baon ka na basics. Tapos i-apply mo yun sa sarili mong gawa. Pero given yung context nga na they highlight realism, they're not very, they don't really promote na you focus on like cartoonish styles, like anime, ganun. Again, not because it's like a bad art style, but because they're also just focusing on achieving realistic rendering. Para, yun nga, it's the basics, master the basics, and then you move from there. Ganun.
Okay, add ko na lang, short na lang dahil ang haba na sinabi ni Kat. Joke na pa, love you. Ang art community ay isang malaking bardagulan center. Kasi makikita mo mga nag-aaway sila, ay, ang realism na yan, wala namang ginagawa yun eh. Kumukopya ka lang na isang image. Ay, ang flat illustrations na yan, nakakairit pa na yung mga malalaking katawan ng tao na maliliit yung ulo na yan. Ay, abstract, wala naman ako naiintindihan dyan. So, lagi ka makikita ang galon na comment. And to be honest, it doesn't matter if may art style ka pag pumasok ka ng fine arts or wala. Kasi you're in school for a reason. Ako pumasok ako ng walang art style at ang alam ko ay realism. At doon ko nalaman na if hindi ka lumabas sa space mo na dinodrawing mo nga lang naman yung ay or pinipinta mo nga lang naman yung isang photograph, parang pumasok ka na ganun, lumabas ka ng ganun, then you didn't learn anything. So, ayun, if pumasok ka naman na may certain art style ka tapos lumabas ka na iba naman yung art style mo, it's okay lang din kasi nga you're progressing as you go through with your studies. So ayun, ayoko na abstract dati pero right now I'm really curious sa medyo nagugustuhan ko na yung style ng abstract. So ayun, so you just have to keep in mind na huwag ka ma-pressure if yung kablock mo may art style siya, marunong siya mag-drawing ng cartoons, marunong siya mag-drawing ng children's book, pero ikaw hindi. Ito lang yung alam mong gawin, mag-render lang. So, don't be pressured. Kasi mali mo siya, hindi niya pala alam kung paano mag-render. So, you have to focus lang sa sarili mong improvement and to keep on finding kung ano ba yung art style mo. And if wala ka mahanap, tapos sobrang diverse ng mga nagagawa mo, mga illustrations or drawings, okay lang din. Actually, it's really beneficial. Beneficial na may isang art style, pero beneficial din pag alam mo, pag marunong ka gumawa ng iba't ibang content. Marunong ka mag-traditional, marunong ka mag-digital, marunong ka mag-drawing ng ganito, ganyan. So, huwag ka mag-pressure if wala kang art style. Kasi it's actually beneficial more than you think.
The last question, and I guess the most important, do you guys have advice for people who are scared to continue or pursue art into their future life na ganyan?
No matter what path you take, palagi kang matatakot. Yun lang yung masasabi ko, na kung ano man yung balak mo sa buhay, there's always going to be risks. But as long as very sincere and lahat ng efforts, lahat, like, buong puso mo, buong kaluluwa mo, binigay mo doon, the risks will always be worth the reward. Even if yung reward, hindi siya something na original mong ina-expect. Because of course, it's normal. It's a given na we're going to have goals, we're going to have certain things that we want to achieve, na dapat ito, dapat ganyan. But goes to show, life is very unexpected. So things don't go as what you would plan. But you'll find it to still be very fruitful. Na parang there's still winning in losing. Kasi parang ano, tao dito, take it as a, people find that failing is like a dead end. Ganun. Kasi, yun, it's normal to feel dismayed na things didn't go as you planned or you worked very hard tapos hindi mo na nakuha to, ganyan. But tapos they're gonna stop there kasi they don't wanna go through that experience of rejection again. But that's bound to happen no matter what you do, honestly. Kasi kahit gaano ka kagaling, it still depends on what situation you're in. Sino yung who you're dealing with at the time, what you're dealing with at the time. Hindi lang kasi ikaw yung factor that you're considering. You could be the very best person, but if you're dealing with factors that just don't complement you talaga, wala kang magagawa dun because it's out of your control. So my advice is control what you can control, which is yourself, your efforts, your skills. It's very cliche, very gasgas, but it continues to prevail. Na you do your best in everything, and when you do things with love, hindi ka matatalo. Kasi palagi kang magkakaroon ng reward doon. May it not be in forms of titles, achievements, medals, or trophies. Nandun pa rin yung content and satisfaction knowing I tried and I did my best. And with what I've gained, I'm going to do it again. Although change is scary, not changing is scarier. Kasi the world isn't gonna wait for you. As in, like, no matter what you do, things are gonna happen, people are gonna do things, and events are gonna occur, even if you don't. So why be stagnant when you also move? Diba? You make changes. So, yun. It's common to be scared of what you're uncertain of. But, isn't it scarier na hindi mo alam yung kalabasan? Na parang, at least pag tapos na, you're gonna be like, ah, ganun yung nangyari. Parang, although the word, like regret is very heavy, I find it better to regret the outcome than regret not knowing the outcome. Gets ba? Kasi at least meron kang sagot.
I have 3 points, but life is like a stage. So, masasabi natin na meron tayong pre-production, during production, and then post-production. Pero these 3 na iiwan ko as advice. So first is, let God be the center of it all and let His will be done. Kasi alam naman natin na kapag si God yung sinicenter natin sa lahat ng ginagawa natin, hindi tayo mag-disalign. So alam natin yung may patutunguhan lahat yon. Then the second one is, one at a time, tapos small progress is still a progress. So darating at darating yung oras na mawawalan tayo ng flame, or ng drive na gawin natin, especially sa art, magkakaroon ka ng art block dyan, tapos mag-breakdown ka and such. In general, life in general. Pero ano, yun lang, dapat tandaan mo na you should work one at a time. Then, may progress at progress pa rin lahat ng nararanasan mo. Then, the last one is, Tagalog siya, pero ito yung pinaka-pinanghawakan ko pagkapasok ko ng UP. Matatapos at matatapos ang araw, pero nasa sayo kung paano mo tatapusin yung araw. So, just be happy and contented. Kasi alam naman natin na maybe yung araw na to hindi sa atin to, di para sa atin to. Maybe yung araw na to para sa atin to. Pero anong gagawin mo para maging sa'yo yung araw na yun? Kasi ikaw pa rin yung may control ng araw na yun. So, matatapos at matatapos yung araw, pero nasa sa'yo kung paano mo tatapusin. So, that's those three lang.
Always remember na matatakot ka lagi. I was afraid when I entered art school, wala akong support from anyone but myself. And I was even scared for myself. Pero I got by. I finished my first semester. And I reminded myself na ito yung first day mo. Just finish the first day and then tsaka ka mag-decide ng gagawin mo for the next day. And to always let yourself breathe. Huwag mong i-beat up yung sarili mo. Ah, shucks, ito lang yung nakuha ko for my plate. Sobrang pangat ko naman mag-drawing. Don't tell that to yourself. Kasi, okay, so what? Kung mababa yung plate mo, alam mo kung ano yung kailangan mong baguhin, then do better next time. And, ayun, as someone na takot, hanggang ngayon actually, takot ako. Kasi, I'm looking at my plates, and then I'm telling myself, what if pag hindi kita natapos? What if late na naman kita mapasa, and pile up yung works ko? And, it really doesn't help me at all. So, usually what I do is just take the day off. If alam kong I can't draw, if alam kong wala akong magagawa na araw na yan, I rest myself and then I just think kung isipin ko lang ano yung mga kailangan kong gawin right now. Ano yung kailangan kong panoorin para maging motivated ako ulit. Kasi promise, unlike sorry sa comparison. Pero ibang courses kasi hindi tayo magbabasa lang, hindi tayo magme-memorize, hindi siya quiz, hindi siya magko-quiz. Performance-based talaga siya. So hindi pwede yung tatabi mo na lang siya ganun. So learning process pa rin. So pag hindi ako makapag-drawing, what I do is I watch videos na lang ng mga nagde-drawing, ng mga skills, or pupunta ako Pinterest, then I look up drawings, tapos sabihin ko, ah, gusto ko ito ma-achieve yung drawing na to. So the next day, pero hindi ko siya gagawin na same day. Like, I take note of that, and then the next day, pa-plan out ko yung gagawin ko, then makakagawa na ako ng plate. So it's really, ano, you have to understand there are days na hindi ka makaka-drawing, but you don't have to beat yourself up. It's normal na hindi ka makaka-drawing. Yung mga blockmates mo, minsan hindi rin nakaka-drawing yung mga yan, pero hindi nila sinasabi. Yung ikaw, minsan may days na feeling mo ang pangit talaga na outcome mo. And kapag inulit mo na lang inulit yung plate, tapos hindi mo talaga gusto yung outcome ng plate na yun, ipasa mo na lang, let your prof judge it. Siya yung sabihan mo na, sir, I can't do this talaga. Tapos, it's okay na sabihin mo sa kanila yung problem mo. They're teachers for a reason. They are people who are guiding you for a reason. Kaya nga, hindi ka stuck sa YouTube lang na nanonood. Nasa university ka, para makareceive ka talaga ng mga feedback. And, huwag ka matatakot sa feedback. Yung feedback na to, siya yung tumutulong sa'yo na mag-grow as an artist. Promise, takot na takot ako sa feedback dati.
It's always going to be hard. Yun nga, even if like naglolokohan na ngayon and there's always this air of thinking na drawing-drawing lang yan. And people also think na when you do what you love, easy lang. It's not. But we're not saying na super not worth it or super sakit sa ulo. Oo, masakit siya sa ulo, but it's because alam namin na nagpuput kami ng effort into it. So, ayun. It's also very normal to have setbacks na, yun nga, tao lang tayo. And when you feel like you're defeated or sobrang wala ka ng energy, ganun, don't beat yourself up for it. And but also know the difference between knowing when to quit, ganun, and knowing when to rest. Kasi sometimes people find it like the answer na pag pagod ka na, ayaw mo na, you quit. But don't quit because it's hard. Quit because it sucks. Na parang, gets ba? Na parang we're going to have to scrutinize it na, do I want to stop doing this kasi mahirap siya? Or do I want to stop doing it because it's not favoring me anymore? There's a difference kasi.
Wow. Medyo na-inspire ako dun ah. Again, every interview na lang ma-inspire ako. Oh my goodness. Like not just for like, yung like school stuff like that, college, whatever. ano rin, like in my own life, I'm like, ah, mind opener siya. Guys, so much for tuning in to Sagot ng SIBOL. And ano, thank you to you guys for participating and allowing us to ask these questions, help out not only our members, pero yung viewers rin namin, and of course, us interviewing you guys. And yun, hope you guys enjoyed this interview. And for our viewers, see you guys in the next episode of Sagot ng SIBOL. Maraming salamat. Thank you.
Bye.